It was a remarkable moment and heart-seeking as well. With this celebration, let me express my heartfelt appreciation for the excellent and well-established cooperation, and I would like to sincerely thank to all of those who supported and assisted us during this 10 years. I am very thankful for all of the people, Hungarians and Swedish, who were involved in the Gripen project planning and in the execution. They have done an excellent job to achieve this success today. It is an honor for me that I could observe our colleagues and partners and the way they demonstrated their preparedness and professionalism. this occasion it is a great pride because I'm firmly hope that the just Rush 39 weapon, by demonstrating its capability and by maintaining a permanent military readiness, made a substantial contribution on the success of our NATO commitments. The Gripen project led not only the Hungarian Air Force to the 21st century, but it was the first big step forward in the modernization of Hungarian Defense Forces, and not only in military equipment area, but in the area of Western time thinking, which was more important for us to the way to be an equal partner in NATO alliance. The initial training led by our Swedish colleagues in Sweden produced for us well-prepared maintenance personnel and, of course, pilots. We became able to operate the Gripen fleet alone, and in result, we were able to accomplish our first 4 months NATO mission in Baltic. We maintained coherence not only in the Baltic, but we parallelly protected our national airspace and maintained coherence under our NATO alliance solely. I sincerely hope that 10 years later, when we celebrate the 20th anniversary of the Gripen aircraft, we all will be here to wake the memories of the past. In the end of my speech, I would like to ask Major General Mats Helgesen to come. I would like to present a small gift to remember this 10-year cooperation and collaboration.
Dear participants, before we go on with the speeches, we are going to listen to the Air Force melody performed by the best Green Air Force band, conductor Lieutenant Colonel Janusz Kopala. Hölgyeim és Uraim, tisztelettel felkérem Varga Tamás honvédelmi miniszter helyettesüket, szíveskedjen megtartani a beszédét.
Mr. Ambassador, distinguished guests, tisztelt nagykövetű, hölgyeim és Uraim, tisztelt ünneplő közönség. A haza olyan közösség, amely biztonságot nyújt, gondoskodást és védelmet jelent, és a szolidaritás elvét követve a nemzet tagjai egymást építő kapcsolatát is erősíti. De a haza nem csak egy életben. A haza jelenti a jövőt, a személyes családi vagy nemzet sorsot is, így aztán a haza fogalmától elválaszthatatlan a nemzeti érzés. A haza szeretete pedig minden időben ereje van, küldetése és hatalma. A haza szeretet hazánk iránti elhivatottság, kötelesség is egyben. Ma is ezen elvek és erkölcsi elvárások mentén működik a Magyar Honvédség, amely a rendszerváltozást követően átalakult, az elmúlt években pedig katonáink felkészültségének, szakmai tudásának és elhivatottságának, valamint a korszerű haditechnikai eszközöknek is köszönhetően társadalmunk megbecsült szervezetévé, ismét nemzetünk egységének szimbólumává emelkedett. 10 évvel ezelőtt 2006 márciusában érkezett a Magyar Honvédség első 5 Gripen vadászgépe hazánkba, majd az első repülőgépeket követte a többi, ám a mai napon hadrendbe átállítása 10. évfordulóján a teljes megújult magyar légierő ünnepeljük. Az ünnepség egyben tiszteletadás a magyar pilóták szolgálatának, hiszen az elmúlt 7 hónapban úgy vállaltott felelősséget Lettország, Észtország és Litvánia légtérvédelmére, hogy egyidejűleg teljesítettük a balti országok és Szlovénia légterének ellenőrzését és védelmét, és Magyarországét is, és büszkén mondhatjuk, hogy Magyarország mindent megtesz a saját polgárai és az európai polgárai is. Így a légtérrendészeti feladatok ellátásával hazánk belépett azon NATO tagállamok közé, amelyek képesek légierőket az országhatáron túl is alkalmazni. Ezen képességünket, helytállásunkat, felkészültségünket 2019-ben ismét 4 hónapon át számítottak a Magyarországon. A 10 esztendő alatt nem csak a magyar légierő, de a katonai repülőtér szerepe is jelentőségnek látható. Azért a repülőtéré, ennek építése 81 esztendeje 1935. március 1-én, a nyomás a puszta melletti területen kezdődött, és átadására 1937-ben került sor. Ugyancsak ez idő alatt történt az 1930-as évek derekán, hogy Szentgyörgyi Dezső, a magyar királyi honvéd légierő legeredményesebb pilótája, letette a mongolokat. Először repülőgép szerelőnek vették fel, de miután az iskolát kiváló eredménnyel végezte, több társával együtt lehetőséget kapott, hogy pilóta lehessen. 220 bevetésen bizonyította hazájának a hűségét, a magyar honvédség hagyományai iránti elkötelezettség. Emlékét és szellemi lelki örökségét emléke előtti fűhajtással óvja és gyarapítja a magyar honvédség és a Kecskeméti repülőtámadás. Így aztán addig, amíg nem csak tudásokkal, hanem szívükkel és szolgáló pilótáink vannak, nem csak jelenleg van az alakulatnak, hanem jövőre is. A 10 éves évforduló alkalmából hazánk valamennyi polgárának megjelen. Ezúton is köszönöm a szolgálatokat, mert nem csak itt van, hanem a misszió során teljesített feladataik révén elismerés és megbecsülést hoztak nemzetünknek és a magyar honvédségnek. Ne felejtjék, a légtérben több 10 millió európai embernek jelent egyszerre nagyobb biztonságot az önök felkészültsége, a légi utántöltés képesség, a pilóták kiállított készülékének használata, valamint a tavaly szerzett és a Visegrádi négyek EU harcsoportba felajánlott close air support képesség is. A magyar kormány az önök teljesítménye előtti tisztelettel is azon dolgozik, hogy a 21. századhoz mérhető körülmények között egy tisztességes és megbecsült életpálya mentén modern eszközök és felszerelések segítségével látassák el feladatokat. Így ezekkel az gondolatokkal kívánok önöknek sikerekben gazdag életet és hosszantartó erőt, egészséget. Köszönöm a figyelmet.
Your Excellency, distinguished audience, distinguished members, the honorable defenders of our home. Poland, our native country, is a community which offers safety, stands for care and protection, and in line with the spirit of solidarity, it also reinforces the supporting relations among all citizens. The homeland is not only a place to live in. The homeland also means a future, personal faith, the faith of the family, and of our nation. Therefore, the national feeling, the patriotic feeling, is inseparable from the notion of the homeland. The love of the homeland has strength, a mission, and power at all times. The love of the homeland coming into our country is also a duty. This is what we call the home defense. The Hungarian Defense Forces have served along these principles and moral expectations also today, undergoing a profound transformation after the change of the socio-political system, and over the recent years, owing to the skills, professional competence, and dedication of our servicemen, the modern defense equipment, they've also evolved into a recognized organization of our society, elevating to be once again the symbol of our national unity. The first 5 Gripen fighters of the Hungarian Defense Forces arrived in Hungary 10 years ago, in March 2006, with the rest of the fighters following suit. However, today, on the 10th anniversary of the Great Panamanian Commission into service, we celebrate the entire renewed Hungarian Air Force. In this ceremony today, we also pay tribute to the service of the Hungarian fighters. In the past 4 months, we were responsible for the protection of the airspace over Latvia, Estonia, and Lithuania, providing simultaneous air policy and the defense of the skies over the Baltic states and Slovenia and Hungary, of course. Therefore, we take pride when we declare Hungary does her best to protect her own citizens and also the citizens of all Europe. Therefore, by fulfilling the air policing tasks, our country has joined both NATO member states, which have the capability to use their air force also beyond their national boundaries. The Baltic countries come from us again over 4 months in 2019 when we deploy our capabilities to put about service and professionalism. Over these past 10 years, not only the Hungarian Air Force, but the role of the air base has also changed remarkably. Of this air base, the construction of which started 81 years ago on March 4th, in 1935, on the site along Lomanchi Field, and which was inaugurated in 1937. It also happened around this time, in the mid-1930s, that Dezső Szentgyörgyi, the most successful pilot, the ace of the Hungarian Royal Hungary Air Force, took his loyal oath as the defender of the homeland, and he completed it. First he was employed only as an airplane technician. However, after he completed his studies with excellent marks, together with a number of his fellow airmen, he was given an opportunity to train as a pilot. He flew 220 sorties as a proof of his loyalty to his homeland and his commitment to the traditions of the Hungarian Defense Forces. Homage is paid to his memory, spiritual heritage, with a bow of thanks by the Hungarian Defense Forces and the Kecskemét Air Force. So as long as their pilots serving not only with their skills, but also with their heart, this week not only is a present, but also a future. Celebrating my 10th anniversary, I take this opportunity to thank you for your service in the name and on behalf of all citizens of our country for earning recognition and esteem, both for our nation and the Hungarian Defense Forces, through your activities not only at home, but also through your missions abroad. You should always remember your professionalism, the media refueling capability, the use of night vision systems, as well as the closer support capability acquired last year, which was also offered to the G4 EU Battle Group, guarantee a growing security in the airspace for several tens of millions of people in whole Europe. With all due respect to your achievements as well, the government of Hungary is working on providing conditions matching the 21st century to allow you to perform your tasks supported by modern equipment and systems along a decent and recognized professional life career. It is with this thoughts in mind that I wish you all many successful years, lasting strength.
Ladies and gentlemen, I have the privilege to ask Major General Mats Helgeson, Chief of Staff of the Swedish Air Force, to honor us with his speech. Sir, the floor is yours.
Minister, Mr. Ambassador, Yenowitz, friends of military aviation, I'm deeply honored to be here today, to stand in front of you, celebrating together 10 years, a decade of flying the Gripens in Hungary. I'm impressed by what you have achieved during these 10 years. On March the 21st, at 3 o'clock, 2006, the first 5 Hungarian aircraft landed there at the Kecskemét Air Base. Hungarian Air Force has done a great job during the last 10 years. There are, in overall, very impressive achievements, which had resulted in a transition to a very modern Air Force with multiple different aircraft. In today's Europe, we need to have a strong air defense. We need to have a strong air force. Among many other things we have performed, we have done air policing over Slovenia with the Czech, and also air policing over the Baltic states. Two really important tasks. The Hungarian Air Force has really enhanced the overall capacity of the European air defense. Your Air Force is an important player in Europe. The last year, you flew over 1,800 hours, and in total, you flew 14,000 hours with the Gripens. You also performed live shootings in Sweden at the Vidsel Test Range. You fired sidewinders and you shot guns. You introduced air-to-air cooling. You are flying with night vision goggles and many things more. Gripen is an aircraft that you easily can fly. You easily can operate it, and it's very easy to land the Gripen. You are also a very appreciated partner in the Greek user group since 2007. There has been a lot of important Hungarian inputs to the Greek user group. A good example of that is the exercise series of NIAF, the first exercise took place here in 2009, the Air Force Base. So from my perspective, we've done a really successful journey in the last 10 years with fighter aircraft. And I also would like to say a few words to the Swedish support group. A total of 27 Swedes, plus our family members, have been here over the last 10 years. There has been a fantastic team spirit between the Swedish and Hungarian personnel. With no doubt, that's a key factor for success. Many Swedes have extended their deployment here to up to 5 years. And after returning to Sweden, they have been very eager to come back to Hungary again. So, Swedish support group, your families, thank you very much. You've done a great job here. And I'm really convinced that you've done the same good impression on Hungarian Air Force as you have found me. You've done a really good job, thanks. Today, you Hungarians are since long well trained on operations with Europe. Therefore, it's time for the support group to finish their work and move back to Sweden. And even if the work by the support group is ending now, we will continue to support you from Sweden. Finally, I want to congratulate all for a great achievement. I'm sure that we will keep close connections between our air forces and a strong friendship also in the future. I wish Hungarian Air Force many more prosperous years operating the Gripen fighters. You have done a really good job. And as a symbol of friendship, cooperation, and future connection, I would like to give a small gift and a symbol to the commander of the Hungarian Air Force, General Albert Chapa.
Dear guests, ladies and gentlemen, we carry on with the delivery of merits. I call upon Mr. Tomasz Varga, Hungarian Deputy Minister of Defense, to be so kind to come forward and hand over the merits. In recognition of his outstanding work and his commitment towards the Hungarian Defense Forces, on the occasion of the Gripen Decade Ceremony, a memento is awarded to Lieutenant Colonel Tomasz Varga. I now call upon Lieutenant General Zoltán Rossz, Deputy Chief of Defense, to come forward and hand over the next merit.
Szóló helyrendelet alapján
recognition of his outstanding work in his post. Furthermore, on the occasion of finishing his military service in Hungary, a memento is awarded to Captain Johann Street, the commander of Swedish Air Force Support Group Hungary. Director of Group and Strategic Program at FMB, and Mr. Erika Alquist, Head of Group and Vice President of SAP, to come forward and deliver us.
Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, dear friends, it's an honor for me to represent the Swedish Defense Material Administration, FMB, on this important occasion. On behalf of my Director General, I'm proud of, together with Saab, to present to you, General Kulik, a symbol of what this is all about. This is the detailed ceremony of the use of Gripen in Hungary, and it's also an important milestone in the cooperation between Sweden and Hungary. I'm also very pleased to recognize the good relations between us and your outstanding improvements as a Gripen operator.
It's a great honor and a pleasure to be here to represent Saab, the OEM of the Gripen system. And I would like to congratulate the Air Force on your achievements. Which is recognized not only in Hungary but also all over the world. As the Gripen provider, we are extremely impressed by your achievements, and we look forward to the next 10 years of Gripen operation. And I would like to assure you that as the OEM of the Gripen system, we will always be there to support your future endeavors.
We in Team Sweden look forward to a fruitful and long-lasting partnership, and also, of course, the next decade ceremony here in Hungary. And we also look forward to a long-lasting partnership in the future. But now, General, please follow us. So, General, please take care of this model of the Gripen fighter in a very special version.
distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. Summarizing a 10-year interval of time is not an easy task. Obviously, I would like to start with the very, very beginning. Following Hungarian's membership to NATO in 1999, there were several proposals to achieve a NATO-compatible fighter force. Considerable attention went into studying second-hand aircraft position, as well as modifying the existing MiG-29 fleet. In 2001, Hungary received several offers of new and used aircraft from various nations, including Sweden, Belgium, Israel, Turkey, and the United States. Although the Hungarian government initially intended to procure the F-16, it was in the process of negotiation a 10-year lease contract for the Gripen aircraft with an option to purchase the aircraft at the end of the lease period. The Gripen lease proposal was financially and politically more attractive, therefore in September 2001, Hungary decided to lease 14 Gripen Lancer 9 A and B. On the 23rd of November 2001, Sweden's Minister of Defense and his Hungarian counterpart signed a memorandum of understanding. Later on in February 2003, the contract was amended to meet the Hungarian Air Force requirements with the Gripen C and B variant instead of the A and B. On the 3rd of February 2003, the Hungarian government signed a combined leasing and sales contract for the 14 JAS-39 CD Gripen of the newest generation that replaced the leasing contract from 2001. By choosing the Gripen, Hungary became the first NATO member state to operate the latest generation high-performance multi-role combat aircraft to fulfill its national, NATO, and European defense needs. The aircraft, specially manufactured for Hungary, is the so-called export baseline standard variant. Ladies and gentlemen, purchasing the Gripen was the beginning of the new era of the history of the Hungarian Air Force. By getting one of the most modern fourth-generation aircraft, we not only got a piece of metal, as we say in aviation circles, but also a totally new approach and way of thinking which was very different from the one we were used to. For example, it was a positive and unusual experience that the Swedish side involved us in the manufacturing process of the aircraft and did its best in the order to meet the Hungarian expectation. The partnership that has been established between Sweden and Hungary, it is incomparable. In the first batch 5 pilots, a group consisting of 19 aircraft mechanics and engineers went to Sweden to complete their conversion training. Later 9 batches and 8 technical groups followed. Altogether, so far, 39 pilots, including myself, and 145 technicians were retrained for the Gripen. Life in Sweden was definitely a challenge for most of us. The common work, the Swedish mentality shaped us in many aspects and made a great impression on everyone. We gained a lot professionally and from the human point of view as well. The first 5 aircraft, 3 single-seater and both double-seater arrived at the airbase on the 21st of March 2006, flown by Swedish and Hungarian pilots. The same year, on the 25th of October, 6 other aircraft followed, and finally, by the arrival at the last 3 in December 2007, the fleet has become complete. The Gripen was declared operational for the QNA task on the 15th of December 2008. And from the 22nd of December that year, alternate with the remaining MiG-29 fighters on duty, providing armed standby protection over Hungarian territory and airspace. The complete fleet replaced the Hungarian MiG fighters by the end of 2010. Dear guests, ladies and gentlemen, I would like also to mention a few things regarding the activity of the Swedish Air Force Support Group. The initial role of the Swedish colleagues deployed in Kecskemét was to provide full support in operating the grid tank. Gradually, through the years, they handed over more and more tasks and slowly only observed what was being done by us. The professionalism, the little tricks, the details related to the operational know-how that we learned from them are priceless, and I would like to express my gratitude for all that. Today is a landmark not only because of the Gripen decade anniversary, but also because the Swedish Support Group ends its activity here in Kecskemét. This fact is a sign of trust. It testifies that symbolically we will become majors for operating the aircraft, and from now on we are capable of manning on our own. This means a lot to us, and it's been a privilege working with our Swedish colleagues. The cooperation between the two nations had a huge benefit, professionally speaking, and definitely we also widened our horizons as a human beings. A decade is a long time. The team was many happenings. I am also really proud of the fact that many Swedish children was born here in Hungary. What's more, the Swedish colleagues started to steal our ladies, which means that relation, development and marriage were made during their staying in our country. So it seems that the Gripen, as a multifunctional aircraft, also had a great multicultural impact. Dear participants, we're talking about the Gripen problem. It is inevitable to mention the most significant exercise that aircraft and our personnel took part in. The first international military exercise we were involved in was on the island of Sardinia in 2007, organized by NATO. The first live firing exercise was executed in 2008 in Lidzen, Sweden, where the largest overland test range in Western Europe is situated. Actually, the very first missile launch was accomplished by the former commander of the Air Base, Brigadier General Lander Kinlan. Thanks to the last area of the test range, besides the live firing, we had the opportunity to practice low-level, high-speed flying, which is not possible in our domestic environment, and therefore it contributed a lot to experience of our pilots. Regarding the exercise, I must mention the Gripen User Group, which is the intergovernmental initiative between air forces that currently fly in the Gripen. Representatives of countries hold the biennial conference in one of the member countries to share their experience of operational use of the supersonic fighter. The first exercise of the Gripen User Group named Line Effort was organized in Kecskemét in 2009. The reason for that is that the original idea of such an exercise was suggested by us. Line Effort is a tactical exercise that intends to enhance interoperability between the Gripen user countries, and it is undoubtedly very useful. In Hungary, the same year, we had the first air-to-ground live firing exercise, which has been repeated every year ever since. Overall, in the past 10 years, including exercise, air shows, and other events, the Hungarian defense and their pilots took part in more than 100 domestic and international exercises, 75 air shows, and other events, and provide their abilities in more than 17 countries, gaining a total of almost 14,000 flight hours. As for the year 2012, it is a remarkable because the Gripen contract that was supposed to end in 2016 was extended until 2026. By this, the original flight time has increased by 95% and according to the new contract we can get the ownership of the aircraft anytime from now on until 2026. Ladies and gentlemen, finally, I would like to highlight two international tasks that are definitely worth mentioning when summarizing the 10-year Big Bang program. One of them is the fact that the Air Force of Hungary and joined Italy in protecting Slovenian airspace under an agreement signed in 2014. It is an important landmark because it's a sign of trust, mutual respect and appreciation of our common values. The other international role we were part of it is the Baltic Air Policy Mission in Lithuania. It is the last quarter of 2015. Hungary participated for the first time in the mission. That has special importance because it's been 75 years since the contingent of the Hungarian Air Force was deployed in another country for a long period. By undertaking this trip, participating actively as a member of the Alliance, the mission aimed to ensure the security of all allies. Through participating, Hungary has joined those alliances that are able to deploy their air force beyond their national borders. Thanks to our commitment and the prominent assistance provided by our Swedish friends, the mission was a great success and a huge experience and also a rewarding task for everyone. We are planning to assume this responsibility again in 2019, hopefully with a similar outcome. Dear guests, in conclusion, at the end of my symposium, I would like to thank everyone who contributed to the unquestionable success of the Gripen program during the past decade. It's been an honor to be part of it. The Gripen is an amazing aircraft and there is no doubt it was a great choice. I'm also extremely grateful for the continuous outstanding support received from the Swedish Air Force Support Group. You guys are one of a kind. On behalf of my colleagues, I can promise that we will do our best to put in practice everything that we learned from our foreign comrades and continue what we started together. Thank you very much for your kind attention.
Dear Minister, Ambassador, Generals, Officers, Ladies and Gentlemen. My name is Johan Sedin and I'm the fourth and last member of the Swedish Air Force Support Group here at the Kecskemét Air Base. During this decade, the support group has decreased from the original 16 persons until today's 2 persons. And in the end of this month, in March, we will close the office for the last time. Relations between the countries have been marked by professionalism, trust, cooperation, and of course, friendship. We are truly impressed by the way that you have implemented a new aircraft system into the Hungarian Air Force. And during this journey, we have learned a lot from each other. We will be leaving Sweden, for Sweden, with no doubt that the Hungarian and the Swedish parties are ready to continue operating the Gripen with the same success as for the past decade. With this being said, I would like to take this opportunity to you on behalf of the Swedish Air Force Support Group to give some special thanks to the Hungarian organization. So, may I please ask the following persons to come forward. General Albert Szafár, the Air Chief of Hungarian Defense Forces. General Szabolcsik, Base Commander, Hírka. Lieutenant Colonel Szoltán Sérki, representing the Department of Armament Development at MOD. Lieutenant Colonel István Asztalos, Chief of Light Operation, Hírka. And finally, but not last, the Chief of Aircraft Maintenance Battalion Aircraft, Major Adam Shambo.
Kérném Landart Eunukur, hogy értékelje az elmúlt 10 évet a svéd-magyar együttműködés szempontjából néhány mondatban.
Alapvetően, ahogy a beszédemben is említettem, 10 évvel ezelőtt érkezett meg a Britten, és az egyik olyan szlogenem, ami a mai napig is érvényes, az az, hogy ezzel a repülőgéppel nem csak egy darab vasat vásároltunk meg Svédországtól, hanem azt a mentalitást is, ami ennek a repülőgépnek az üzemeltetéséhez kell. Ez a mentalitás nagyon-nagyon fontos ahhoz, hogy sikeresek legyünk a jövőben is, és az elmúlt 10 évben is ezzel a repülőgéppel ami sikereket el tudtunk érni. Ez nem csak a vasdarabon múlik, hanem magán az emberi hozzáálláson is. azok a feladatok, amit az elmúlt 10 évben végre tudtunk hajtani, itt kiemelném a tavalyi évben a balti országoknak a légtérvédelmét, ezek mind öregítették a magyar légierőnek a hírét. A NATO tagországai olyan visszajelzéseket adtak, hogy teljesen meg voltak elégedve a munkánkkal, és nagyon-nagyon várjuk azt, hogy a következő nemzetközi feladatokban részt vehessünk. Ebbe az évben január 1-től a Visegrádi négyeknek a harccsoportjába szereplünk, mint szárazföldi erők közvetlen légi támogatása. Ez megint egy olyan feladat, ami teljesen új a magyar légierő számára. Ennek a feladatnak is meg tudunk felelni, úgyhogy örömmel tölt el, hogy ezeket a feladatokat végre tudjuk hajtani.
Szakmailag mekkora előrelépés történt a légierőben az elmúlt 10 évben?
Alapvetően, ahogy említettem, a MiG-29-es, amelyik egy harmadik generációs repülőgép volt, és a keleti szomszédunktól vásároltuk, a Gripen beszerzéssel egy negyedik generációs repülőgépet tudunk magunkénak. Ezzel a repülőgéppel végre tudunk a 21. századnak megfelelő feladatokat hajtani, úgyhogy ez egy óriási előrelépés a magyar légierő számára. Alapvetően, ahogy említettem, a levegő-levegő képességekben alkalmasak vagyunk arra, hogy bármelyik országnak a légterét megvédjük, ami a NATO országokra is vonatkozik. Levegő fölképességben, mint említettem, a Visegrádi négyeknek a harccsoportjában benne vagyunk, tehát alapvetően a levegő fölképességeink is bővültek ebben az évben.
Meg egy-két számadatot, hogy összesen hány repült óra, hány pilóta volt idáig a
képzésen? Ahogy említettem, az átképzésen 35 pilóta vett részt és 145 technikus lett átképezve Svédországba. Természetesen ezek közül a pilóták közül nyugdíj, más beosztásba helyezés miatt kevesebben vannak már. A műszakiaknál is természetesen ez már kevesebb. Közel 14 ezer órát tudtunk teljesíteni a 10 év alatt a repülőgéppel.
Hány gyakorlaton vettek részt a Gripenek?
Ahogy említettem, közel 100 gyakorlat volt külföldi és helyi hazai gyakorlat, ahol részt tudtunk venni. Több tíz országban megjelentünk repülőnapokon, valamint magáért beszél, hogy a szlovénia légtérvédelme is jelenleg a Gripenekre hárul.
Svédország részéről is szóba került, hogy még az együttműködés az ezután is folyamatos lesz. Ez milyen formában valósulhat, meg milyen például?
Alapvetően az, hogy a svéd támogatócsoport itt befejezi a munkáját, ez azt jelenti, hogy felnőtté váltunk és megkaptuk a jogosítást arra, hogy magunk üzemeltessük. Természetesen a gyár és a svéd beszerzési hivatal nem engedi el a kezünket, továbbra is az ő kooperációjukra van szükségünk, a további anyagellátás továbbra is Svédországból fog jönni, csak ezt már nem a svéd támogatócsoportnak a tagjai fogják innen rendelni, hanem a magyar katonák fognak ezzel dolgozni.
Thank you. tartani kéne, ne arra gyújt!
Thank you.
Thank you.